All right, everyone, get ready, because in this deep dive, we're stepping into the funeral home, and let me tell you, this short story is going to stay with you.
Oh, absolutely.
It's, well, we're going deep into the text, really trying to unpack this funeral homeowner's experience with a client, a Mr. Valentino. And it all starts so, I don't know, normal, I guess.
That's what's so interesting about it, right? It draws you in with this ordinary setting, everyday life, in a funeral home. It's almost like we're getting this inside look at a world we rarely think about.
Yeah, exactly. You're right there with the funeral director, almost like you're eavesdropping on his thoughts. It's a quiet life, kind of solitary, you know?
Yeah.
Dedicated to his work, even a little, what's the word, quirky. Like, he was found as a baby right outside an orphanage, so the funeral home, it also sounds like the family he never had. But then Valentino walks in, and everything changes.
Totally. That's when the story starts to, I don't know, unsettle you a bit. The author drops these subtle hints, little details about Valentino, like the smell of sandalwood cologne he has on or how weirdly calm he is. It's all designed to put you a little on edge, like something isn't quite right.
For sure. You don't see someone stroll into a funeral home every day, completely at ease, ready to plan their own cremation, and the things Valentino asks for. Super unusual. His whole demeanor just makes you think, okay, there's a story here.
Yeah, it makes you wonder about Valentino, you know, like why this need to disappear without a trace, no memorial, no fuss. It's almost like he wants to erase his past completely.
Like he's trying to become a ghost before he's even gone.
Exactly.
And speaking of ghosts, our funeral director is caught in a tough spot. Business has been slow, and Valentino's offering a hefty sum up front. But something feels off, you know? Did he suspect something was wrong right away, or was it just how strange Valentino was being that made him hesitate?
Well, that's the question, isn't it? The funeral director, he's wrestling with his conscience, his morals. I mean, this is a guy who's literally surrounded by death every day, and even he's thrown off by Valentino.
It makes you think about the weight of the decisions he has to make.
Absolutely. And that's where funeral home really gets under your skin and makes you ask, what would I do?
And just when you think you've got a handle on things, the story takes this sharp turn. Imagine this. He unzips the body bag, expecting, well, you know, and it's Valentino's face staring back at him.
Whoa!
I know, right? Talk about a twist. It's like the author just throws this massive question mark at you and you're left spinning. Is it a case of mistaken identity? Or is there something more, something unexplainable going on here?
Right. And that's where it gets really interesting, because it's not just a simple ghost story anymore, is it? It makes you question what's real, what you can trust, even your own senses.
Like, did the funeral director, did he just imagine that whole first encounter with Valentino? Maybe the stress of the job finally got to him? Or could there be something else at play, something we just can't explain?
That's the beauty of it, though.
Mm-hmm.
It gets under your skin and it stays with you long after you finish the story. It makes you think about all those little details, you know?
Oh, absolutely. Like Valentino's instructions for his cremation, how he wanted everything so simple, so anonymous. And then there's that sandalwood scent.
Ah, yes. That sandalwood cologne. That wasn't just a random detail, was it?
No, definitely not. It's like it followed you through the whole story. A constant reminder.
It's like a piece of Valentino himself. You know, this lingering presence, even when we're not sure he was ever really there.
Yeah.
And the fact that he specifically left that cologne for the funeral director. So strange.
Yeah, that part really got me. It's like he wanted to leave something of himself behind, tied to this man, to this place. But the story doesn't end there, does it? It takes another turn, and we see what the funeral director does after, well, after everything.
Yeah, his decision to close the funeral home, and not just retire, but like completely wash his hands of it. That's a powerful statement, don't you think? What do you make of that?
It's almost like, remember how Valentino wanted to just disappear, to erase himself? Well, it seems like the funeral director, he kind of takes on that desire himself. He's not erasing his past, though. He's erasing his future, his whole livelihood, all because of this encounter.
Yeah, it's like he's haunted, but not just by Valentino, by the whole experience, you know?
It makes you think, what was going through his mind? Was it guilt? Fear? Or was it something else, something more profound that made him walk away from it all?
It's like he saw something that changed him, shifted his whole perspective, and he just couldn't go back to the way things were.
Definitely makes you think twice about things, doesn't it?
It does. And that's what's so great about the funeral home. It's not your typical ghost story. It's more like it makes you think about life and death and what we think we know about it all. It's those moments, those cracks in reality where logic just disappears and you're left with this feeling like something more is out there, something we can't explain.
Exactly. And maybe we're not supposed to explain it. Maybe it's about accepting that there are things we just don't, we can't understand no matter how hard we try.
And that's okay. Sometimes the not knowing, that's what stays with you, what makes you really think.
So there we have it, everyone. We've gone deep into the funeral home, explored its twists and turns, but more importantly, the questions it raises. Did we just witness a ghost story? A man wrestling with his own mortality? Or something else entirely? We may never know for sure, and that's okay. The beauty of a story like this is that it stays with you, makes you think, makes you wonder. And that's what we hope we've done here today. Got you thinking, got you wondering. Until next time, keep exploring those mysteries. And remember, sometimes the most interesting answers are the ones we never find.